It's kind of very exciting to consider that the future of the world is being started there.
The UN warned us that in the future there is a possibility that only 20% of mankind would live in the countryside. I think that would be such an incredibly both dangerous but also kind of simply simplistic and an absurd neglect of all kinds of potentials.
The Guggenheim is a place where great artists question the future. It's not a labyrinth of galleries. It's a linear narrative, but it cuts back in time and space. Rem's ambitions with this project are as big as they've ever been in his career, and I really don't think there's another place that could hold such ambitions as the Guggenheim. I think it's fitting that he was actually the first architect to ever exhibit in the Guggenheim in 1978, and today Rem is now pivoting his 50-year-long career away from cities to the countryside, and of course he's doing it at the Guggenheim. Countryside the Future is a mixed media exhibition at the Guggenheim with Rem Koolhaas, Samir Bantal, and AMO that's meant to make you think differently about the countryside.
It's the forefront of modernization, something that we thought the city was. Countryside is still the place where new ideas and experimentation actually take place.
From the very beginning, Samir and myself were doing this together, and Niklas Mack, who is a German writer, would be an important contributor. We then also extended our network to collaboration with different universities. Harvard University, the University of Nairobi in Kenya, the Chinese Academy of Fine Arts, the University in Holland.
We are engaging in conversations with experts, with scientists. We have teams of researchers that are in the field, interviewing, listening, data gathering, and analyzing all that data.
Countryside is such an enormous subject. I wasn't even going to try to encapsulate it. You know, my contribution in this case is not something particularly shaped, but almost an unedited waterfall of questions. It's kind of really exceptional that the New York Art Institution dedicates itself to a subject which is more sociological, political, or anthropological.
What's special about Rem is he has an almost preternatural intuition to sense where the future is brewing. And with this project, he's doing that all over the world. I'm the Guggenheim curator leading the project, but there's many curators on the project. But the building's also a curator. So you've got the countryside existing in the city. You've got Rem Koolhaas, AMO, and their collaborators coming up with ideas that need to fit into the Guggenheim Museum. And then you've got the Guggenheim Museum and its mission and its staff and its expertise. And all of those things have to come together in a kind of way.
I think that this exhibition really demonstrates what makes every exhibition at the Guggenheim so site-specific. The building is so unique, and this exhibition really leverages that.
Working with the Guggenheim felt really easy, because with the experience that the museum has of making really exciting shows, there was nothing that seemed to be too challenging for them.
The robots are a really good example of that. They sent a rendering with an object on a Roomba, and they were like, what if?
That is hands down a first, that we would have automated machines operating alone on the ramps with visitors. I think one of the things that's also really interesting about this building is that it always has a voice. Inviting somebody new to come in and understand it and then react to it always leads to something entirely different.
Every ramp has its own theme, and every theme kind of has its own conclusion or starting point. And by actually connecting all these ramps together, you are able to understand an enormous, dense exhibition like this.
Right when you enter the exhibition, you're confronted by 1,000 questions written by Rem Koolhaas. So don't come here looking for answers. The show actually ends on a note of optimism, a super high-tech future that looks like a world that we used to live in. The 1,000 questions boil down to a single question at the end. What world do you want to live in?
Ah, pixel farming. It looks beautiful.
I
got the kind of crazy, wonderful opportunity to contribute to this show by offering some of our research as an example of what's happening on the cutting edge of agriculture. What I hope is the impact is that people see that there are alternative avenues being examined to get people thinking about creative ways of imagining the future. Samir and Rem walking onto our farm that day has now come back to manifest as really new, exciting collaborations, and I'm really excited to see where that goes after this.
A very important political message is that in order to work on all the issues that this exhibition raises, communication is the most important thing. No exhibition has had such a big impact on what I think and on what I want to do as this one.
Rem Koolhaas' idea for why we should dive into the countryside is because that's where the future is already present. And by better understanding what's going on in the countryside, we can be better stewards for our own future.